Good morning, everybody. How are you? Welcome to the show. Hopefully it turns out all right today. Never know where I'm going. In fact, I'm just jumping on here and I'm just going to start doing some doodles. And I kind of got an idea in mind, but I'm not sure how it's going to work. We'll sure give it a try, though. This actually comes up here. Ooh, I like that idea. Yeah, 106 people. Hey, I hope you're, thanks for everybody for joining in. My name's Brett Wynn. I'm a professional artist and I just started doing this. This is my 21st episode. I've been doing this every Monday through Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern. And I tell you what, the response has been great. It doesn't look like I've got a lot going on right now, but trust me, trust the process. I think you're going to find something pretty cool that comes up out of this here real soon. And that's what I like to do. I like to make sure everybody is involved. You know, I want you to see the process. I want you to experience it. And in the end, maybe inspire you to paint. And you can see all I'm doing is just little scratches and doodles and everything. The only time I'm going to get real serious is probably about right in here. Because this is my horizon line, basically, and I kind of cut it out right here. But in that horizon line, I want some people in here, and I want them to be fairly dominant. So I'm going to just drop a couple people on this little path, and I want them to connect and be part of each other, so they're more of a unit, I guess you could say. One piece, I guess, and then we're gonna have a little shadow with them. And oh, let's see, there's gonna be some more shadows coming out this way because these trees are gonna be really big up in here. So, thank you for sticking around to see what this is going to be. Well, let's start with some color now. This is actually so simple. This little process that I'm doing here, I hope you like it when this all turns out. This is just a simple shapes. You add pretty color to simple shapes and you can really come up with something nice. So let me demonstrate. I hope y'all are enjoying this so far. Good morning, Days Arms. Nice to have you join in. Let's see, I got stuff. Oh, there's my brush. So while I'm talking, I decided to switch over my .com on my profile. It's still there, but now I've put up a link tree because I had so many questions about my supplies, types of paints that I use. And good morning, Tanya. Nice. Oh, you're a watercolorist. Okay. I'm going to have to follow you. I got to remember this. Let's see. I'm going to look you up in a few minutes and we're going to make sure. If I don't follow you, make sure you follow me and I'll go back through and get everybody covered. And oh, hey, Lalo. Oh my goodness, I can't pronounce that, but thank you for following and thank you, Tanya. I love learning from other watercolorists. I just enjoy this medium so much. So let's get started. I'm going to make this. I don't want to go super wet. You know what I just realized? My assistant isn't working. Let me see if she'll work for me. Alexa, studio lights on. Alexa, studio lights on. There we go. Hey, that's a little better. We were just using natural light from my window, which is also nice. But that helps a little bit anyway. So I'm going to give this just a little damp. I don't want to go too heavy. I'm going to bring it right down to this point, at least for right now. And let's see, did I leave a little hot? Yeah, we got some bright areas that we're going to leave right in there. Okay, let's go with some, start off with some, let's see. How about some cobalt, just to pop in some color? I like the cobalt. Cobalt is pretty. Can make a pretty sky. I'll go a little heavier. Bring that down just a little bit. And my green, I have a sap green, but I always mix it with so many other colors, and that's what I'm kind of doing right now. So I've got a sap green and some lemon yellow. And I'm gonna pop those in these little areas too, where it's still wet if it starts to dry up. And that's the one problem with this process, with this lighter paper, is it kind of dries up quick. So let me get some of this in here. And there we go, there we go. Isn't that fun? Good morning, Abigail. And seal, I don't know what that means, but hey, Eric, thank you. Let's see. Okay, so we're gonna put some more color. I'm trying to pay attention to all your writings and everything, and I appreciate you commenting. If I miss something, hit me up in one of my comments. This will be posted later, and I'll be happy to answer any questions. Okay, let's get a little bit of some lighter. This is a yellow ochre I'm going to pop in here, just down in here in this area, but not too heavy. I'm going to push it around so it's over in there. And as we get over in these areas, I'm going to get some more blues and the green in there. Some blues down in here. And we can come all the way up into this area, I think, safely. Maybe even over here. And let's see, just a little dab of color there. And maybe even as we work our way down, let's see, what should I add? Because we got some nice light colors in here, some cool colors, I should say. Maybe I'll bring a little bit of this. What is this called? Oh my goodness, I'm losing my thoughts here. Sorry guys, I get so involved sometimes, I just lose it. So thanks for sticking around and enjoying my ramblings there. Well, that's what I wanted. I wanted a little bit of yellow ochre in here just to warm that side up, because I've got this kind of this cool kind of sky color, and then it gets even to these yellow or yellow warmer colors, and then a cool blue, and then a warm. And then I'm probably gonna drop in a little bit of cool again right on the edges just to have some fun with that, because there's nothing wrong with color. Color is what makes watercolor so pretty. He's not a Bob, I know. I really wished I was, but you know, and he was a big influence in my life growing up. I will tell you that. I'll tell you that. But I got my color palette. Look, I'm gonna help you out. I got my color palette right here. It was out of my view a minute ago, so now I'll know what colors I'm looking at when I put them down. So my apologies. My apologies, Pam. We're going to get this right, though. And let's see. And you know, the bad thing is with watercolors, I can't beat the tar out of my brushes like Bob did. I loved that. I just thought that was so cool. Okay, we're going to take these colors and kind of push them back up in here and make them look like trees that are way off in the distance. And that's all I'm doing, is I'm taking that color that's already on the page and pushing it back up. So I'm on about a 5 or 6% angle, referring to the Afro-con. Oh, you know what? You are absolutely right. When I am no Bob Ross when it comes to that Afro. I am about as bald as it gets. Oh, goodness. See how quickly that dries on this cheaper paper? That's okay. We can probably play with that a little bit more. Let's just pop in just a little bit more of that blue on the wetter surface. There we go. And as we work our way out, I want to put in some of these more, let's see, lemon yellows. I don't want that to turn green, though. So just a little bit of that lemon yellow. Just right in some of these areas. Probably should have been a little heavier with color. Very cool. Now let's get some of these trees back up in here. Still playing with that. Oh, look how quickly it's drying. That's the only bad part. Okay. That'll probably be the last spray I do. But it's still doing what I want it to do. It's staying pretty light. This is kind of giving me health problems right here. Now, in a couple of days, in a couple of weeks, I'm going to be moving on to a different kind of paper, and I'm kind of hoping that some of these problems are just resolved. We will see. Okay, I think we got what I'm after here. It's nice, bright colors popping through this little area right here. So now I'm going to bring my colors down. This is where I'm going to start bringing in some browns. This is going to be my, my burnt sienna. And I'm just going to pop it right on the edge of there and let it start coming on into there. But we want more than just brown, though. We want some pretty colors. We want these to be nice and warm now. So I'm going to bring in some alizarin crimson through here. And I'll make it a little rough in areas, too. You can put in a little orange if I wanted. Because there's nothing wrong with a little orange here and there. And we've got blue, and the reason why I like the orange idea is because we got these blues that are popping in here, and pretty oranges will kind of bring out that contrast between the two. Good morning. What type of paper is this? Oh, good question, Tanya. This is actually an inexpensive paper. I've got it on my on my link tree. If you go to my artist supplies, you'll find it. I can show you real quick. It's this Canson. The link is right there if you'd like to get it right off Amazon. I tried to make it convenient because I found that as I was doing these, this being only my 21st episode, I found a lot of people had questions about what I was using, so I'm more than happy to answer that kind of stuff. Now, see what happens. We got this red. What's the complementary of red? Now we're getting closer in the picture, so it's going to be a little heavier. And what's going to be the green? Watch this. Ooh, I like that. And let those little blossoms up. It looks like there's little bushes growing on down in there. That's so cool. Oop, I got a little hair there. And that can kind of start running up with some little bushes. Maybe it's up back in here. Yeah, there we go. There we go. Let's see. Eddie, let's see. Oh yeah, you're brave. Not a fan of that. let's see. Morning, I use pastels. Afraid of watercolor. Glad you're doing that. Well, thank you so much. I love pastels. I really do. But I tell you what, my pastels look more, by the time I'm done, it looks more like a child's Crayola crayon drawing. And I've tried oil. I've tried the regular. It's just, I don't know what it is. But I do love acrylics. I do love, of course, watercolor, and I'm planning Ed. I don't know how that means. I'm so sorry. I'm just going to say E. I give up. I'm so sorry. I know I'm terrible when it comes to this stuff. Your name, I'm so sorry. I'll look you up, though. I will look you up and see if I can pronounce you right. My apologies. And Stacy, you love graphite. Karina, thank you for following. ED, okay. Thank you for that. Thank you for that. Edie, did I get it right? I hope so. Yes, Edie it is. Thank you. Oh my goodness, terrible of me. I know, terrible. Okay, I want to put in a little bit more. We got the greens and the blues over here. Or not greens, excuse me, greens and reds. Let's go more yellows over here. And what am I going to put with yellows on this side? But as I work my way down, how about we'll put in, make it so it kind of goes a grayish color by putting in blue. Excuse me, I'll tell you what it is. It's cobalt blue, alizarin crimson, which gives me a nice little purple. And I can start bringing in these purple shades down in here for that. And that makes that all nice and pretty. You'll see this, how this all comes together here. And now let's get into the water. See, this is supposed to be a path, a little walking path. I think I'll just make it kind of a grayish, neutralish. So that won't take long to do, just like so. simple, and then we're gonna move on to everything that's going on over here, which is basically a reflection of what's going on up here. So, we're gonna make this go a little quicker, I hope. So a little darker greens right in here. Well, that didn't work out. How about getting some paint on my brush? Good morning, Brandy, how are you? And all the people that followed, Mace Quill, Gail Oliver, thank you. Monica Hopper, thank you for following. You make it look so effortless. I'm just starting my hand in watercolor. Just finished. Well, congratulations. Hey, that's the first step. You gotta finish it. You gotta get that one out the door. And then let's see, there's a little bit of red. Let's see how this all is red here. I wanna get that little bit of red that's glowing down in there and some more down in here. Let's see, I try to make it look effortless, but honestly, these mid-tones are what do it. All these mid-tone values is what's really gonna make this work. That's what'll bring it all together. So I just still have my people over here. It's still pretty bright, it's still bright there. I wanna make sure that it stays bright. If I'm gonna measure this properly, it would be, I would take my horizon line, I'd go from here to here, I'd go down to here to here, see, but it's not really. See, it's clear off the page. So I'm gonna fake it just a little bit, and I'm gonna leave this area right here more open and start putting in some of the other colors that are representative up here. Let's see, what was some of that blue? I liked that blue. Blue was kind of nice. I'll get some of the blue in there and then draw a nice tight edge right here. And then we're gonna leave that spot open like I was saying. I'm gonna soften the edges with just some plain water. And that, I think, we'll really finish up the first layer. I know, right? Do you fill in the white spots? No, I love the white spots. Sorry I missed your question there. How long have you been painting? I've been painting since I was about 2 years old, according to my mother. As soon as I was able to get something in my hand. Hi, Kim, I caught you live, hey. Yeah, anyway, as soon as I was able to get something in my hand, apparently I was marking up the walls with anything that would put a mark on a wall. And I'm gonna dry the stuff off real quick, and I'll get back to the rest of that story. Okay, sorry about that. Oh, some AMS, sorry. white spots look like snow. They will a little bit, but they will actually start looking like reflective qualities of the light and everything. And some I cover up as I go, some I leave. It's a work in progress. You've gotta kind of follow the process, trust the process, and it'll all come together. So I'm just getting comfortable. I'm gonna sit down on my chair and take a look at the screen, answer a question or two. Thank you for the likes, I'm so much appreciative. Look at all these 84 people, I'm sorry, I had a whole bunch more earlier, and this drying thing always makes everybody run away, so my apologies, so hopefully people will come back. And my wife just came in with my puppy Raiden, and I'm sure Phoebe will be coming in just in a moment. Hi, Beth.
Hi.
Everybody say hi to Beth.
Hi, everyone.
Mm-hmm. Okie dokie, let's draw some. Let's get in the middle tones. Good morning from Boston. Nice, Boston. Hey, there's Brandy saying hi to you. Hey, look at everybody saying hi to Beth. Welcome, everybody.
soon.
You do? Oh, you gotta go.
No, it depends on how they act.
Oh, the doggies?
Yeah.
Oh, they might have to go soon. Yep, you're right. We'll see.
Sometimes.
Naomi, you became my top viewer. Thank you. You're awesome. Let me get some color in here so I'm at least somewhat entertaining for y'all. You've been sticking around long enough. So now what I want to do, I want to start adding,
Good morning, Nancy.
Oh, Nancy's there. Hi, doggies. Let's see. Yeah, we got Phoebe and Raiden here today. So now I'm still going to be adding more textural colors in the background. It's still kind of fuzzy, still kind of way in the back. Let's see what we got here. And then I want to soften the edges. This paper is so tricky. You just got to kind of play, let it do its thing. Regular paper, or really the paper that I would use for my work. Paper that I would use for my larger pieces, the ones I would sell, usually don't give me so much trouble. So like this edge just wants to be hard and I don't want it to be hard. So I'm trying to do this lift, but the paper is so fragile and thin, it sometimes doesn't want to play nice. So that's where we are. But I still want that nice pretty glow going in there. So we're gonna try to leave that in. And at the same time, I've got the warmer yellows here. So I want to put some cooler colors. Let me get a few of those cooler colors in here, some greenish blues, and we're just gonna dab those in real quick. And push some of these up. They don't even have to really look like much of anything. We're just trying to create a scene, a story. And honestly, most of this is coming out of my head. I don't, you know, I know I've been on a, we've all been on a million paths, especially when you're, can you stop right there? It's awesome. What brand weight do you, weight finish do you use? Oh my goodness, there's so many questions. I need my wife to come in here and help me answer some of these questions or ask them. It does kind of look cool, but you'll see. It's gonna get cooler, I hope. I have overworked a few, but we're gonna try this. So we're getting some of these cool colors in, and we're gonna, as we get over here, I wanna get even darker. Mix some of the blues and the, what is that, a Prussian? Ooh, yeah, that's Prussian blue. Ooh, look at that green. Isn't that cool? Let me put a little bit of that over here, too. I kinda like that green. Okay. Don't you worry, y'all. Soften some of these edges, you'll be surprised. And then, let's get some of the colors that we need down in our ground. And of course our person is right here, but we're not gonna touch him quite yet. We're gonna get some of these middle values into him, or her, or the couple. Let me use a little smaller brush and I'll show you what I mean. Doesn't really matter the color, it just matters the value. And that's what I like about watercolor. I'm just gonna... I think you can see I'm not going much darker than the... let's see, have you used watercolor paper blocks? I have not.
Did you answer the one about what brand weight
finish you use? Oh yeah, right now I'm using, well for this I'm using Canson, but for my regular fine artwork that I do, I use Saunders Waterford. That's my preferred brand. I know that there's some other ones out there that I would love to try one day, maybe Fabriano. I've used Arches, and honestly when it comes to Arches and the Saunders Waterford, it's really preference, I believe. As many artists as I've talked to about it, it just seems to be preference, what you've used the most and what you're most used to. So, with that said, let's get on with some more of this stuff going on. I want some more blue right in there. Is that too heavy? No, it's not too heavy because we're getting closer up here into some of the details. And that means I could connect this right here, and you'll see what I'm talking about here in a minute.
Which means so Jim likes that Fravio hot press 300 pound.
Oh yeah, I mean Fabriano hot press. You know, I used hot press in college, and it was great for when I was illustrating and all of that. But I haven't really used it for watercolors because I miss the texture that comes along with the cold press. But I do love it. Okay, there's a creature in green blue in the left. You talking about that guy right there? This little guy is like waving. Do I need to fix him before he jumps out at my two people?
He's the Yeti.
Oh, is that the Yeti right
he's
there?
Bigfoot.
he's only 2 feet high, but he's got size 18 feet. He'll probably disappear in the long run. You'll watch. Where are we at right now? We're at 25 minutes. I've been yakking away. I need to get some paint on this.
That's okay.
I know. Okay, so we've got the mid-tones. We got enough mid-tones, though. I think we do. No, we don't. No, we don't have nearly enough. What am I talking about? We got a lot of work to do. I need to stop yakking. Okay. I ink. It's smooth so the pen doesn't skip is what I need. I get it. I totally get that. Yeah, I love, like when I'm doing illustrations and whatnot, I love that smooth texture for sure. Okay, so here is where we get to really get to play. You can see I'm using green and browns in here, right along this edge. You'll see why here momentarily, because in just a second I'm going to take the blue, the blues and the yellows and everything that I've got going, I'm going to connect those right to here. Now that just became a tree or some type of a shadow.
How do you know when you have enough mid-tones?
What's that?
How do you know when you have enough mid-tones?
Well, there's a lot of there's a lot of paintings in the garbage that didn't make it because I overworked the mid-tones or I didn't have enough of them. So that is a real thing. But I try to connect midtones. That's kind of the goal, and to make these real pretty. And connect the midtones and try to have just very, very few super dark areas. I go overly heavy on the darks. Okay, so great news on something. I'm just going to go ahead and share this with everybody. My wife and I were panicking, more so than me. But, of course, I caused a lot of panic. Sent off a commission, and it showed up last Thursday to the home. But the buyer didn't go look until today, and it wasn't there, so we were freaking out all morning. So that he just let me know that he finally found it. So thank goodness for that. So you want that bright area right here to kind of show. And then there's that spot up here that I told you I was going to kind of fake in, so we're just going to fake that right in on there. And I'll put in some water. And these can be the trees. See, these are reflections of trees. They can be anything you want, really.
Okay.
Yes. Am I missing some questions?
If you're looking at this up close on your phone, extend your arm and look at it from distance.
Oh, I see. No, I see what you're. Oh, are you talking about my Yeti thing still? Is that what we're talking about?
I don't know.
Oh my goodness. Whoa. See, what I'm doing actually is I look up at the TV,
so
which is off to my left.
Left.
Is this my left? This is my left.
Yeah.
So what's up here?
There's a monster in there.
Oh, there's a monster up in here?
Maybe. Ooh. Oh, look, eyes.
Oh, is that the monster, this thing? And the skull? Oh, we'll make that go away. I promise I'll make that scary thing go away soon. Oh, thank you. That's Edie. I was pronouncing her name wrong when she came.
Edie.
Yes.
Yeah, two eyes in the mouth.
Two eyes in the mouth. You're sure right. I see it now. Dang it. Now I've got to get it off. Now I'm going to have to take that off of there. Don't you worry. When I get to the dark layers, which is coming up, that'll all go away. I think I've got enough. Do I have enough glow for the skies?
Yes, she found it.
Took me long enough, didn't it? Oh, my goodness.
We're a little slow.
We are. There goes my crazy dogs. They'll learn. They'll calm down, I'm sure. Give them a few minutes. Or not.
They will if I leave the room.
Well, yeah. Because then they know Daddy's in control and they'll get in trouble. Okay, from here, I think I've got enough connections made with the midtones all through. I'm sure I could make a lot more. But I think at this point, I'm gonna get the small brush out, get some, dry this off a little bit, get some heavier paint and start doing some of the darker colors that will really make this all come together. And I do appreciate all the follows. Yes, we love dogs and cats. I can't unsee it now. Okay, dang it. I gotta unsee it. I'm gonna unsee it right now, everybody. We're gonna mix some colors here. Oh my goodness. Let's see. Now I'm mixing pretty dry for this next layer. Some neutral tint, some sap green. Opposite of green is alizarin crimson in this case, so that also helps with the color and creating pretty grays instead of just kind of dead, yucky grays.
Okay, I know what it looks like now.
What does it look like?
It looks like it's called K-T-K? Stop.
Taka? Is it Taka? Taka?
So it's the villain off Moana.
Oh my gosh, that's so crazy. What are you doing popping up in my painting? Well, you know what? Just like any bad villain, it needs to be destroyed, right?
Yes.
Oh, goodness. All right, here we go.
And there's a ghost right above the people on the right. Yeah, that's
that one here. We saw. Yeah, we saw that one. Okay.
Or maybe in the blue, looks like a ghost, the tree line. You're gonna have to, are you trying to hide stuff in there today?
Mm-mm.
You playing Where's Waldo?
Yeah, doing Where's Waldo today. And as we work our way back, we're gonna get lighter on those trees. And skinnier, so let me grab a smaller brush, lighter. Work our way down. And onto the other side, we'll go from the lighter ones first. And as we move our way closer, we'll get them a little darker. Where was my cool mix that I was using? Now it's just all kind of gone. It went so fast. There we go. Now I'll be a deep tree right in there. So let's bring some over here, out that way. We're just having all sorts of fun now. And watch that little ghost go away. Oh, he went away. Go light back in here. And then lighter. Okay. I'm liking this where it's going so far. Okay, he's gone and creature. All right, let me get a few little small ones. I love this brush. Where did he go? There it is. This is my, I call it a rigger brush. It's got all sorts of different names, I think, but it's really fun to add some of this stuff going on in here. And of course, I'm going heavier initially. And I need some flicks going on.
Oh.
What?
You got rid of the Yeti.
I did. I got rid of the Yeti. Dang it. Sorry, folks. I got rid of the Yeti. Okay, so what makes a watercolor pop? That's the big question. What makes the brights bright and everything else but dull? That's trying to get your darkest darks closest to your lightest lights. And that's what I've done right here, and that's why everything else is kind of faded out. So let me get those guys down where I want them. They're almost there. Darker. There we go. Over this side. And then we got our little line over here we gotta take care of. You can hear my dogs are having a good time, aren't they? Closer to the front, this line needs to get much darker and with more detail. So instead of just doing these lines, I might have to actually start putting in some little grassy shapes or something. Who knows? Let's see if we can figure something out.
Okay, do you have...
What's the matter? Are you talking? Thank you, Lisa. Much appreciated. Yeah, a little darker on this connected area. What happened?
Oh, they need fresh water.
Oh, I just filled that.
You know, if there's a little speck of anything in there,
they're gonna get it. I know. They're picky dogs. We have very bougie dogs. Let's put in some bright. Should we little bits of bright color straight? Almost, I'm not gonna say straight from the tube, but still heavier colors.
There you go. I made a pelican and then covered him up.
I did. And what this is allowing me to do by bringing in some of these little colors in here, it's helping me bring some of this little reflective quality down into here.
Phoebe, that's your brother drinking.
Which should help. And then you see this detail here, is here, that's here. So if I come up here, so you got all this dark down in here that I need to work on. So I could just do this. I could just go to, I had the alizarin crimson. Let me use my different brush. I could just tap in, let's see. How about right here? Just tap in a little bit of that color. More of the orange, I remember that was more orange. Yeah, more orange. That should help with that. Maybe even a little darker. Yeah, there we go. That warmth kind of helped against the cool, the warmth and the cool. And then from there, quick, I don't even think I need to dry it, honestly. Let's see, let's just go. There we go. Okie dokie. You made a pelican, then covered him up. I miss the sound of dogs playing. Oh, well, I'm glad I'm able to. I'm glad my dogs are able to entertain you anyway. What would you do to make leaves? This one really is pretty impressionistic. There's not many leaves I would do on this, but if I was going to, especially seeing how there's all this heavy color, let me see what I can do. What I would do is I would make smaller branches and get some darker greens in there too. Something that even pops heavier on this area up here. So I'd probably come up and just start tapping in some little leaves. It doesn't have to be anything fancy by any means, just little bits here and there. Of course, the darker, the lower you get, the more obvious, and the closer you get, you know, you might have even more. But really, I'm just kind of scratching them in. I'm not doing anything fancy. Just give the illusion of, or the impression of, seeing as how, I guess that's where it gets its name. So yeah, there's some leaves for you. I hope that works. Funny the things people see, paint, imagining. Imagination is a great thing. I mean, I was one of those kids that would stare up in the clouds and I would see every little thing. That's just one way to just tap in some leaves and give some indication of.
It's beautiful. It all came together so fast.
Well, thank you. And you know, you can put different colors, different places too, to just make it interesting. That's what's fun about watercolor. Just pop things any old place and see what happens. But the main thing is, for this painting to work, it had to have the darkest dark next to the whitest white. So that's why that is like that. And let's do some scrub, maybe some scrubbing-ish. Let me see if I can find a brush that I would be willing to almost destroy. Yeah, see, there's another way you can take your brush and just tap. Do an old brush though, don't use a good brush. And almost straight ink. I mean, straight out of the tube. It's not straight out of the tube, but it's in the, there's very little water in the pen. If you want to reflect this color here, you could actually come in, because I'm just going off my own intuition now. I'm really not, this is just me making stuff up. Green, what goes good with green? How about some red down in here? A little bit of something going on down in here, who knows? And then because it's got red, you want to make it give it some dimension. And by doing dimension, you just drop in some blues down at the bottoms of those. And that'll blend in and make a nice grayish color. Now I've got little flowers going on. If I want to make them brighter, I can put some highlights just by tipping some of these little bits. There's something going on over here. Where are we at? We're at 15 minutes too. Trying to see if there's anything else I could do that would really make this work better. Yes, making this even darker would make it be better. That's what would do it. Not a lot help. That didn't help a lot, but whatever. Whatever. Thank you so much. Me too, and I'm painted. Oh, cool, cool. Let me see. I'm going to try to get some of that off of there. I don't like that. I'm going to just push some of this away. Maybe even lighten that edge up a little bit. I just put paint down when I was supposed to lighten it up. That's awesome. Ha! Try that again. Well, I guess we could say it's getting overworked. I guess I should probably stop, folks. But I had fun today. I appreciate everybody stopping by and watching. The only thing that I would really do different if I was going to keep going with this, I could for the next 15 minutes or so, is I would start adding little bits of dark areas and little bits of white. So let me just show you what I mean. Like just to give it some dimension, you can put this little shade, this little thing here. Maybe it was a rock. Maybe this is a rock. Maybe this little yellow thing down here has some shade to it or something. So just try to create dimension out of your lights and your darks. And white, of course, for the highlights. I don't see a lot of areas where I would put highlights in this because I think I was fairly successful in getting the darkest darks and the lightest lights together this time. I could definitely maybe put some reflective or some reversed out branches. And of course, add some of that down into here. Still keeping their little shadow in place. And some water lines. Did I miss something?
A lot.
Oh, I'm missing a lot? You don't want to read them to me, do you?
I don't.
Oh, what does that one say? Oh, how hard to lift. Yes, it is hard to lift on this paper. Oh, well, I had to leave for a second and come back. Amazing. Oh, thank you so much. Let's get this to make it look like water. Let's see. An old painter said to me once, if you paint a cloud a day, you will become a great painter. This is true. I believe that. Got to go, but always love your lives. Thank you so much, Christy. Hope you're still there to hear that. Jeez, looks great. You're awesome. My wife had to catch me up. To use gouache on for the white. I will either use gouache or I will use acrylic. When you're using a little tiny bit of acrylic, it doesn't give the shine that heavy acrylic that it would if you do heavy acrylic. So honestly, it's whatever I have closest to me. Today, it happens to be just a little bit of acrylic. What is my dog after down there?
I kicked the ball and it rolled under there and he
wants it, huh?
He got it.
Oh, he got it. Oh,
he
good
was
for him.
Very good at it.
Good. lines. And I'll put a little, just a few little white lines by the dark lines. Again, that's just to create that contrast, some directional lines to lead people into the painting, to where I want the, where I actually want people to be looking. Uh-oh. Somebody else.
Raiden yelped.
Yeah, Raiden yelped. So yeah, our dogs get playing with these toys and they'll end up trying to take them from each other and turns into a tug of war, and sometimes they get a little too close to one of their jowls. And... yep.
And it's always the puppy that gets the bigger dog.
I know, that's the funny thing. Can you say bigger though?
No,
because our puppy weighs more than our other dog. So I think we're going to call this one good. Some things I like, some things I'm not real crazy about. I wonder if I could try to fix some of this, maybe. I don't like how this is so see-through right here. I want it to be heavier. Yes, heavier. And I would like it to also be... more tapered. And yeah, these are things that a really good watercolor artist would have hit nailed the first time. I am not that person sometimes. But I fake it till I make it. Am I missing questions again? I hope not.
What happened on your thumb?
Oh, that's always a question. Age. We'll just call it age. I mean, I want you to see pretty paintings. I don't want you to see my ugly hands. And just by adding that extra bit of dark, you can see it's already just made that look so much more bright. Let's do this. Final touch. What is the final touch? And then as soon as I get this signed, I will go ahead and take the tape off, which is always really cool because then you can really see what's going on. And while I'm at this stage, for everybody that's stuck around watching, I really appreciate it. I kind of wait to the end because honestly, I want the true followers, the people that are really enjoying this, to hear this. So I believe in the whole algorithm thing, but what I believe in more is true, organic followers sharing stuff out when they really like it. And if you've really enjoyed this, I would so appreciate that because, I've seen a lot of people get a lot of artists on here. They end up getting a lot of bots or they get people that were just, oh, that was kind of cool. And they never come back and never really engage, and you know, I want this to be an engaging, fun community, so I definitely would appreciate that. Now, if you would like to support in any way, shape, or form, I'm not really into the tipping thing. I appreciate the tips, those go right back into the studio. However, I do have a lot of my art on notebooks on Amazon. You can get them in 2 days, literally 2 days. I'll show you a couple of them. As soon as I tear this off, and I do appreciate you sticking around for all of that. So here we go. Here goes the tear. I love this part. Gives those nice clean edges. I did get pretty heavy on the water. You can see that, but there might be a few more of those goofy things. I could have done some splatter effects down here to give some flower. Can make it look flowery too, but we did what we did. Top piece and the bottom to make it look all clean. See, if I get really big goobers, I don't mind doing this either. I will do this totally. Where was my white that I just had? Oh, there it is. Take your eye off of it for a second, your paints will disappear. Just cover that up a little bit. Nobody will know. No one will know. No one will know. There you go. There we go. His wife is also, yeah, I know, we're all lefties. Isn't that funny? Just realized he's a lefty. Okay, now you said, I was talking about the books. Let me grab the books real quick. Let's see which ones I have to show. Oddly enough, you know, I've learned that art is definitely one of those things that people, you know, one person likes one thing, another person likes another. I made these books in the order that I thought that they would sell the best, and that was not the case. Here's one of them right here. I'm not from, but I live in Virginia, so blue crabs are really big for us. So I did this blue crab. You know, let me zoom out real quick. Zooming out. Yeah, so anyway, what happened there? There we go. So yeah, I did this blue crab, and you can get that right on Amazon super quick. And what you've got inside is your journals, note-taking, list-making, whatever you are. Everybody seems to use paper these days. Oh, where are they walking? Where are my people walking? They are just walking off on a... Good question. You can do wherever you would want them to walk to, just a couple having a good time together, I guess. And then, so I've got this one. I thought this would be really fun. You know, it's kind of a little bit more masculine. It's got that woodsy, mountainy effect. And then I've got this acrylic that I did. This is more, it's getting to be fall, people. Just make a nice fall notebook for you to be carrying around. And then I loved my lavender fields. I thought this was just so, impressionistic, and it just came together really well. I loved it. But the one that's been selling the most is the one that I actually had a little bit of content in, and that's this one. This is actually an affirmation journal, and yeah, you can definitely swipe to the left, look at my link. You'll see that I have my Amazon thing here, but this is just so fun. You get your date, you get the what you're grateful for. Let's see. Here's what you make today, or here's what would make today great. See, all these different things to help you get your day started off great. So this is one of the things that you can definitely help to support. This is on Amazon. I think they're like five, six bucks. And totally have this really cool velvety feel that makes them really fun to hold. So anyway, are they walking their dog? I should have had them walking dogs, huh? I didn't even think about that. I love them all. They are making their dogs. They're walking their dogs. Hey, they kind of do look like they have dogs in front of them with a heavier shadow. That's what I love about Impressionism. Everybody sees something different and it just makes it so awesome. So anyway, yeah, if you'd like to do that, we've got this stuff over on Amazon. My other links will take you to my my prints. And I just released a new print called the Climbing Trio. That's assigned and numbered. I'm only going to do 25 of those. So once they're gone, they are gone. So, and of course, because they're signed and numbered, the value typically increases quickly. So anyway, with that said, I want to thank everybody for sticking around. I am going to get this video up online, and I'm also going to be working on taking all of these full-length videos and moving them over to TikTok, or not TikTok, what am I saying? YouTube, so you can watch them in full-length, slow motion, or you can come here on TikTok and watch the time-lapse. Anyway, either way, I'm just rattling on, so I'm going to go ahead and be quiet now. Y'all have a wonderful day, and we will see you tomorrow, Wednesday, 10 a.m. Eastern. Have a great day, everybody. Oh, is it Thursday?
No,
tomorrow is Wednesday. Yeah. Yes, Wednesday. All right. No worries. Have a great day, everybody.